Yes.
Oh, yes, big.
Big fish.
But no matter what you've caught, or even what you've seen, there is always a bigger fish, a tougher fish.
Yeah, got it.
And it's out there. It's out there somewhere.
He's hit a bite. Seriously, something tugged on that.
Uh-oh.
Oh, look at him! Look at the shark right here! Look at the size of
him! A massive shark has got it. That is the biggest Mako I've ever seen, bro.
Okay, watch out for that shark. Keep an eye on the shark at all times, because he will come to claim his catch.
Today, we're launching off an isolated beach in the far north of New Zealand. The air is crisp and calm, the forecast is good, and we've got a basic plan. The sort of plan that most fishers start with. Catch some nice fish to eat, then challenge ourselves with some big tough fish. And as always, there's that desire to catch that ultimate fish. Part of the endless search for the perfect day's fishing. So we've got all of the gear, we've got some know-how, and just out there, an ocean of potential awaits. Whoa! Whoa! Today, we're looking for some of the huge kingfish that are known to feed in the shallows along this remote coastline. And to get them, we're going to be trying more than just the traditional rod and reel.
Going to spearfish.
I upped the ante to get in the water to hunt a kingfish. But this is the ocean. And sometimes, you get much more than you bargain for. And to crank things right up, the next plan is to catch the ultimate of all big game fish.
He's going nuts.
With only my hands and a bit of string.
Oh, look at him! That was a huge one, bro, and it did a full flip.
The question is, when that ultimate fish comes out of the deep blue and we've got it hooked up, can we handle the next surprise that the ocean throws at us?
Mate. Look at the shark right here! Look at the size of that!
That is the biggest Mako I have ever seen. Be careful of this Mako.
But before we can chase the big kingfish and huge swordfish, we first need to catch some bait fish to feed to them. And while we're at it, maybe a few fish to feed us as well.
Well, setting up a burley trail at daybreak, you'd be forgiven for thinking that we're fishing for snapper. However, we're not. We are fishing for the blue kohiru, and that is because they are the ultimate live bait for a kingfish. I'm still going to chuck a bait out for a snapper though, because it's daybreak and we've got a burley trail going.
We're in 18 metres of water here, and there's snapper swimming around on the surface. Right, I need to get on task and get towhee fishing. The thing with the blue kohiru is the time of the day. Daybreak is the time to catch them. And they're not to be confused with your jack mackerel, they're quite a different fish. And if we catch one, I'll be able to show you the quite obvious differences.
Oh, that wasn't a kohi. What was that on? Just your little bait?
Yeah. Might have been a kohi, only a light drag on.
Oh yeah, that would be nice if it was a kohi.
I mean, they can go, eh?
Oh, they can go pound for pound. Imagine if a blue kohiru grew to 50 kilos.
Got one something or other. Hopefully it's what we're after.
It's a bit better.
Nah, it's not a kohi, you can just tell with a fight. It's another blooming snapper. Biggest.
Different. This might be one.
Kohi?
I don't know, maybe. Nah.
What is it, Mal?
It's a snapper.
Ay, ay, ay. A bit more like it, maybe. Feels a bit like a kohi, perhaps. Ah, it's a mal. Stink one.
Well, no blue kohis here, but we're not giving up. Well, not yet, anyway.
We're eventually going to have to catch some kahawai or something because we've got no other live baits. So, off to find another spot.
I've often found that when bait fish are hard to catch, the fishing for the big stuff is excellent. It's like the bait fish know that all the big fish are hungry. So if we can just get some bait, I'm certain we'll see some big fish action.
Blowing snappers everywhere we go.
Can't get away from them.
The plan I've made today to catch some big fish hinges on catching some bait, the elusive blue kohiru.
Oh, somebody just ate it right there.
And we just can't seem to catch them. So we've switched our focus to catching another popular local bait fish, the kahawai. A tough fighting fish in their own right, the kahawai has been the bait I've used for some of my greatest ever catches, from snapper and kingfish through to marlin and sharks. So these kahawai will make a good substitute for the kohiru. But while we're targeting bait fish with tiny wee baits, Julian has hooked into something a little bigger. And it's another reminder that when you're fishing in salt water, you never really know what the next fish is going to be.
Well, I guess if you're going to catch kahawai, this does make it a challenge. Fair snapper. Might be an alright snapper too. Is that on one of those little spread hooks?
Targeting snapper with ultra tiny hooks and baits.
Now, Julian's hooked a snapper on a bit of bait like that, while at the same time, I had that out there, it's been untouched.
Oh, look at it too.
Yeah, I can't bring it over.
Oh my goodness.
Far out.
Look at that.
There he goes.
Yeah, snapper sitting back there, eh? Not a blue koi though. It's a common sight to many Kiwis. A snapper coming in. Typically you'd be quite happy with that. But it's not the snapper that we want right now. Going home. Away he goes. Snapper.
Not a blue
koi. Oh, you want that net?
Oh,
you got my
here.
Line here.
That's right, if it comes off, it comes off. See how strong these little hooks are?
Yeah, brilliant.
Look at that. He's even bent. Look, he's even... Oh, shizer.
Oh, it's a reasonable one too.
Look at that, he even bends the hook out and it's still stuck in there.
Well, as much as it looks just fantastic here to burly up and continue snapper fishing, that's not what we're about today. So we're going to have to leave the snapper biting. Oh, fine snapper they are, that one might have to come home for food. And use the kahawai that we have caught for live baits.
Fucking fish.
He's a fatty.
Fattest one caught.
I'm in.
You got him.
Far out. He's a cracker.
We're only in 11 metres of water here.
Pass me the tack pole. I'll get it. No, you just drive the boat. Keep going towards him. Keep going towards him. Slow down. Slow down. He's a big one.
Slow down.
Ah! The tag went in. The tag went in. There he is. Look at the size of him. Oh, there's a shark's got him.
So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app so wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv. Today, we have perfect weather. So I've headed out from a remote region in the far north of New Zealand, where me and my good mate Julian are on the hunt for a big fish and continuing our search for the ultimate day's fishing. We've had a slow start to the day, struggling to catch bait, but now we've found a likely looking spot where bait fish are teeming on the surface. Just the sort of spot to find a big predatory fish.
Well, in goes our bait, and we're kingy fishing. Okay, mate, all yours. We're gonna have a cup of tea.
plenty of kahawai, which is food for kingfish, which is why we're here.
Oh, there's loads of kahawai. There's gonna be a king here.
Yeah, yeah. I'm in.
Yep, okay. Right up on him, mate. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You want to grab that helmet?
Yeah, I'll grab the helm.
Far out, he's a cracker.
Oh, yeah. The cowboy does the game. I'll follow him out, we'll try and I'll try and drag him away from the rock.
Yeah.
We're only in 11 metres of water here. We'll get some angle on him, I reckon. You can go up and over that button if you want. There's heaps of drag on that 80.
He's still wet. Yeah, nice fish.
Good stuff. Okay, we're in 40 metres now. 40 metres. We're moving away from the danger zone. Now, what we're trying to do, as soon as I came in over the rock there, that's where the kingfish was, just below the school of kahawai. He's come and eaten the kahawai. And the first thing I've done is guided the fish away from the rock. And we're out in 37 metres of water, but not out of danger. You're never out of danger with these things. I'm just gonna keep idling out, eh?
Yeah.
So you can afford to give him a little bit now if you have to.
There he is.
See him?
Nice fish, too.
Oh, look at that. Nice.
Not a bad kick.
Yeah, let him go, mate, if you have to. Just, I don't want to have to actually grab him when he's all angry like that. We've got our still camera here, eh? I think he's a photo-worthy fish, that one. That's a reasonable one, eh?
Yeah, nice fish.
Let's just have a look at that. Give him 20 kilo a nudge, I think. Oh. Live baiting. It's real simple, real simple. Catch a kahawai, chuck it on, and tow it around the rocks.
Oh, oh, oh.
That's a great photo, yes. And here's how to turn a 20 kilo kingfish into a 24 kilo kingfish. Hold it like that. The bottom of the shot is going to go up this way too, mate, for cover of fishing news. Okay, ready? When you're ready, mate, let him rip. There you go, he's powered away. Beautiful. Well done.
Well, next plan involves this bag.
I just jump in the water and take a look. Now, while the water's pretty dirty, as in the visibility isn't very good, on a day like this, with all this bait fish around and kingies here, I am ultra keen to get in the water and check them out. And if the right opportunity presents itself and the right fish, I've got this, because we're going to take just one fish, so we might as well select it from under the water. Going to spear fishing.
When hunting for any fish, you look for their food. And in this shallow terrain, the kingfish mainly prey upon mackerel, kahawai, and kohiru. So that's what I'm looking for. However, I first come across large shoals of blue mau mau, so I sink down through them in the hope that a kingfish is lurking below. As I dive, the mau mau scatter. This creates sound and vibration that the kingfish detect, and they come to investigate. But on this occasion, I decide not to take a shot, because the rocks are just a few metres away, and the powerful kingfish will likely drag my spear gun into the rocks and destroy it. So instead, I hitch a ride and get the boat to drag me out to deeper water. There's no sense in burning up too much energy just yet. I've got a big day ahead.
This is how we live bait for great whites up here in the far north. Put a man in a wetsuit, looks kind of like a seal. and tow him along behind the boat on a rope. And hopefully we get a good shot.
After spending all morning trying to catch a blue kohiru, I'm now surrounded by them. They're here with the trevally, mau mau and kahawai, feeding on the tiny krill that drift helplessly in the current. These guys are small and fast, so they're a difficult target. But I take a shot anyway. And finally, I can show you the elusive blue kohiru.
Been trying to catch one of these things all morning. The elusive blue kohiru. I think I shot him quite high, so he should live for a while. They're actually part of the tuna family. Just the blue kohiru, stunning little fish. Don't drop them. Precious. You got him?
Yeah.
Bring him up, mate. I'll put him in the tank if you're not ready.
Here's the blue koeys. Like a small tuna, they are the primo kingfish live bait. Like lollipops, the kingfish.
Once again, I've found a shoal of kohiru. And like all predators, kingfish are never far from their food. So I shoot another kohiru, but this time I leave it to attract kingfish. And out of nowhere, the kingfish hone in on the distress signals put out by the kohiru. And they are so fired up to eat their favourite food, not even a spear deters them, and they grab and bite at the kohiru, until finally, they smash it right off the spear, and it gets eaten in a single gulp. So now, I reload, breathe up, and then go back down to take a shot at a kingfish. Underwater, it's hard to gauge the size of these kingfish. I don't want one too big to eat, but I must take care to only shoot fish that are of legal size. So I choose one, take my shot, and it charges off with my spear gun. Now I've got to put on enough pressure to keep the kingfish out of the reef below, but not so much to cause the spear to tear out. And after a to and fro tussle, I finally get the kingfish under control and get a good firm hold.
Got him! Oh, yes. Well, we always said we were going to take a kingfish. Oh, we've let plenty go, but this is a great way to earn your kingy. That's the one for the smoker boy. And that completes our kingy. Spear, just watch the spear.
Woohoo! Nice fat kingfish.
We've got the kingfish we were after, and there's still plenty of day left. So now we're setting our sights on the horizon and heading offshore to look for big game fish.
Oh, look at the marlin feeding just here.
And here at this time of year, that could mean a big shark, a tuna, or a marlin, and possibly the ultimate big game fish, the broadbill swordfish.
Okay.
But no matter how big the fish,
oh, look at him!
I get reminded there's always a bigger one out there.
What, look at the shark right here, look at the size of that.
That is the biggest Mako I have ever seen. That is massive.
He's got our swordfish, and Mako has grabbed my big sword, look.
We've had a great morning at the inshore reefs and islands.
Nice.
Fishing and freediving for kingfish.
Got him!
So now, we're venturing offshore to see if we can turn a good day into an epic day by catching a mighty broadbill swordfish from my small trailer boat. But we've not yet reached the swordfish grounds when we encounter another big game fish, the marlin.
Oh, look at the marlin feeding just here. Oh, right in front of us. Look, right. Oh, he's just about to run a marlin over.
Just seen a marlin feeding. It's soury.
Where were they? How far away? Straight ahead, eh?
Yeah.
Keep your eyes up
for those souries, because that's where the marlin will be.
I thought, no, won't even bring any marlin gear this trip. It's all about the swords. What do we see? Straight away, a marlin feeding.
The marlin are too focused on the bait fish they're feeding on to look at our bait.
Nah, we're gonna leave him, bro. We're on a mission, sortie mission.
So we get refocused on our mission to catch a swordfish. And I've hatched a plan that has never before been attempted. And if it comes off, it's going to be epic.
We're gonna be using our traditional Tiagra 80 wide, caught plenty of big game fish on that. That's for Julian, whereas me, on the other hand, I've caught a few swordfish, so I'm gonna make a bit more of a challenge and go for my hand line. It just remains to be seen how it's all gonna play out.
The first step is to rig a bait and then get it 600 meters down to where the swordfish lives in complete darkness.
There'll be some small black dots at every 10 meters, yep. But the big ones are every 100. Oh, that's it there, eh?
Stop it on the next black dot.
It's a whole lot of work for one hook, but you get that one fish, man, it's a pretty special fish.
That's it there, was it?
Oh, got a bite.
Yeah,
just hit a bite. Can you grab my gloves out of there? And we'll start, seriously, something tugged on that.
Well, we're trying to bloody figure out what the heck's going on with this rope. Something tugged on it, man, definitely. Definitely. Holy crap, we weren't ready for that.
There was just like boom, 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 just like your classic swordfish bite. So they come in with their bill, bang, 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 and hit it. Hopefully he comes back and eats it.
I wonder if it was just a blue nose or something trying to eat it. Whether it was a sword trying to grab it.
I think what we'll do is, like, as I haul in, just leave me a little bit of slack, not enough to tangle, so I can let it go a bit.
Yeah, sure.
And our safety plan is, if I start screaming, cut, 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 grab a knife and come to me quick. And cut in front of me, not behind me.
Man, this is deep water hand lining. Yeah, there's something pulling on that. Yeah, mate, we got, oh,
we had something on, then it pulled the hook. I felt it just go real heavy, then we dook. I wonder if I should, see, I didn't know whether to feed it slack or what. Far out.
Because it's the first ever drop that we've done with this thing, it's hard to know what's going on. Now, at least now we've got a bit of experience with catching them on rod and reel. And it's very unusual. It's the opposite of what you might think. The mightiest fish of all, the swordfish, you think you'd get a tremendous bite. Not at all. They're down deep, 600 metres down. You've got all that line out. They bite it, and they might eat it. You can't feel what's going on, and then they start swimming to the surface. So, in fact, everything goes light all of a sudden. Hmm. Interesting. I wonder what bit it.
Yeah.
Well, rather than just sitting around here and waiting for a swordfish bite on my hand line, I'm going to leave the hand line right here. Essentially, it's like a one-hook long line. And I've attached a light to the top, which is activated by darkness, because if we hook up on a swordfish, well, could be a while before Julian winds his swordfish and we get back to this. Or that could hook up on a swordfish and bugger off 10 miles. And it's just gonna make it easier for us to find it in the middle of the night with a light on it.
Right. See if our spared blue koi will get you a sword, eh?
Right, we're just having a bit of a break in our showy offy hand line hijinks for now, and we're just going to try and get one on the rod here for Julian.
Light packs, but definitely something.
Oh, yep, that's pulling out. See what happens there.
Yeah, there's something going on there.
Yep.
Yeah.
See that?
Yep.
Yeah, there's something on there, I think. We've hooked something.
Hey?
We've hooked something. Get that gimbal belt. Oh, hang on, no, just let go. Bugger. There was something there. Bugger. Now, that might not have looked like a whole lot was going on then, but I think that was a swordfish bite. 600 metres down is so far down, it's just so hard to tell what's going on. Oh, has that gone slack?
fairly slack then, didn't it? Now it's gone light again.
Nothing there, eh?
It's real light, man. Neutral here.
Yep.
If I had to guess, no, I don't want to say. Ain't gonna say nothing. Absolutely no way, don't hear it all. Oh, I just thought it was starting to get heavy then. Oh, it is starting to get heavy. Keep getting heavier, keep getting heavier, keep getting heavier. We're on the mono, it's only 100 metres from the surface. And I'm alright, bro. That way I can take most of the credit for winding in. I've wound in the first 500 metres, we're only 100 metres to go. Tell you what, I'll wind in the first 550, you wind in the last 50. Yeah, I think we've got this. I think I'm not going to say, yep, we're tight. Yeah, okay, yeah. I think you'd better take the rod now.
Right.
Take this last 50 metres for us, eh?
Okay.
Hey!
There he is, he's out there, look, oh. Jumpy.
Sword, yep, it's a broadie. One. There he is, jumping on the surface. We have got a broad ball jumping, I'll chase him.
Okay.
You got your harness ready? Just sprint your line. No, don't worry, just wind. I'll hook that in later. Got a sword jumping on the surface. Oh, yeah! That's a rare treat to see a broady jumping, man, I tell you. A very rare treat indeed. To be this close. See what I mean? See, it's so curious. They're so enigmatic. Just the way that they bite and come to the surface and explode out of the water like that one did.
He's right here.
Oh, he's right here. There's a sword right here. Hang on. Where's my wiring gloves? We're going to get a look at this fish. It's been, what, minutes? Okay, the tackle's here. I'm looking. I need you to grab him. I need to. No, I'm not. There's a sword right here. Look at him.
Oh, he's off.
Wait. It's going under the boat. Okay. It's a swordy. And it's a nice sized sword, too. And we got him quick, boy. Look at that. I've got him on the leader. He's caught. Caught fish. Grab the tackle. Grab the tackle. And there's our sword. Just tag him. And that's tagged and released. And what? How many minutes is that? He's going to be a beautiful one to let go because he's hardly fought. Look at that. He's not the biggest sword in the world, but he's a nice one, boy. Bro, that's how you catch a swordfish real quick. Not always cracked up to me. We got bigger fights out of those kingies. Okay, now the hook's going to be a bit of a trick to get out. Watch that sword because we've seen what they can do. Any day you catch one of these is a good day. It's a better than a good day. Look at this. We've got such a well-behaved soul. Speak too soon.
All right.
And that is why they are regarded as being so powerful. Oh, this boat's got to go to the boat show in the next week, buddy. Just trying not to scratch it up for me.
Grab that bill up front.
No, mate. Be careful of that bill, mate. It will waste you. I reverse the boat. Put it in reverse. Reverse. Oh, I just don't want him to rear up. Okay. We're going to let this guy go, eh, while he's fresh. Keep still so I can get a photo, bud. Oh, photo on my jumper. Awesome. Do you want to see if you can just grab a hold of that hook? I'll keep his bill under the boat.
Yep.
And just see if you can wrench it out.
Yeah, before you go.
Yep, that's your sword, bro, right there. Okay, now we've got the bill wedged under the boat to stop him hurting us while we remove the hook. But if we can't remove it, we're better off letting him get back down. There you go, you got rid of it. Okay, I'll kick the boat in gear and we'll tow him with us just a little. You got the hook out?
Yep.
Let go of the hook. I'm just going to get the pole.
He's away.
He's away?
Yep, he's gone.
Yeah, that's a real quick sortie. He wet us a wee bit, and look at that. We've got our bait. I love it, man. Would you want to live anywhere else where you can do this? Never mind those marlin we ignored on the way out. Seen a few feeding. We were on a sortie mission. We better go and pull this float in. It's probably got a sword on it.
Oh, that buoy's moving along, isn't it?
Yep.
You know, that sailing, man.
Jeez, we might be onto a bit of a mish here. We might have a sword on there.
Look at that, eh?
There's a fish on here. That's for sure. Oh, jeez, he's shaking around all over the show. Nah, he's going nuts. Oi!
Oh, that buoy's moving along, isn't it?
Yep.
You know, that sailing, man.
Jeez, we might be onto a bit of a mish here. We might have a sword on there.
Look at that, eh?
Okay, now we've got to grab our float. Okay, reverse just straight the way it is. Now the hard part. I've got to haul 800 metres of line in, and
hopefully a big sword.
Okay, now I don't want to be wrapping up on this line, because when the swordie goes, I've got my release knife, all good.
The blow's starting to head back down.
There's a fish on here, that's for sure. The trouble with this is that unlike Julian's fish, we were right there as soon as it bit and it charged to the surface, we were about to take up that slack line. This fish has come up to the surface and now he's charged down deep. And I've got my work cut out for me, that's heavy, man. Well, I can drive the boat myself pretty much from here. That sun's beating down too, autumn they say. I've got a swordie on my hand line.
Oh, yeah.
And that's what I wanted to happen. Man, I spent so many hours thinking about how I'd do this mission. So many hours thinking what sort of line would work, what sort of weights, what sort of float system, enough to keep it up but without being too hard that it would break or pull the hook. And well, so far so good really, eh? Still at 350 metres to go. Oi, oi, oi. Do you want to start winching a little bit of that in and I'll start making a neat pile? We've got enough of a... Oh, stop, turn it off.
It's bloody,
I don't think he wants to talk about it.
From the underneath,
Because particularly when this fish is about to run, this is not a good time to have a tangle. I'm just going to try and hold him, but I don't want to snap that leader. His line angle's coming up, the sword
coming
might be
up.
Coming. Yeah,
he might jump.
He might jump. We might see him up on top soon. I can tell you that he's exactly 300 metres away, because there's my 300 metre join. Well, right now, I don't have to worry about driving the boat, because this swordfish is just dragging the whole boat along quite easily too. Well, essentially, I'm dragging the boat along because I'm pulling against the resistance of the fish. I'm really worried about a tangle here, man, because this fish is going to go at some stage. I ain't going to be able to stop it. Here in my bloody thing. Keep hauling, bro, keep hauling, brother. So I'm running out of space to put my line up here. He's winding up now, I can feel him beating his tail. Oh. Okay, stop whining. Bro, we've got to sort that tangle. I'm not going to be able to hold this fish, eh? Here, I'll drive up on him, take the weight off. Yeah, we're just going to have to make sure we've got to kind of really get a compromise between having some reserve line to let it run and not having so much that it tangles. This is kind of putting the onus on me now because we know that line won't pull out off that winch once it's engaged. So I've got to really hold on, pull a bit harder. The danger there is we snap the leader. We're a lot further now than where we caught Julian's. It's heading out to sea. So it's coming up for a jump or something. Something's happening. We're going to see him up on top soon. He's pretty close as well. Yeah, I reckon he's swimming about 4 or 5 metres down below the surface somewhere there along there, Dave. No, he's going nuts. Shaking. She's shaking around all over the show. Uh-oh.
Okay.
Look at that jump! It was a huge one, bro, and it did a full flip, bro. Man, you just don't get to see that. Look at him going nuts.
That's a big sucker.
That's a big one, all right, boy. That is what I'm talking about. No, I think he's shaking it, eh?
Got nothing.
No,
he's still there.
Thrashing around. No, but I don't think I've got him hooked. I think he's free. He's broken the line and he's just thrashing around trying to get rid of the bait. Yeah, look, here's my bait. He's free. Let's go over and see him. A massive shark has got it. That is the biggest Mako I've ever seen, bro.
We're on a fishing trip that started off with a beach launch, followed by a few snapper, a nice kingfish, then a quick spearfish.
Got him!
We're now 25 miles out from the beach where we launched. We've tagged and released a swordfish, and now we're hooked up again, this time on a handlock.
Okay. Oh, look at him! Look at that jump! It was a huge one, bro, and it did a full flip. I think he's free. He's broken the line and he's just thrashing around trying to get rid of the bait. Yeah, look, here's my bait. He's free. Let's go over and see him. Grab the tag pole. Pass me the tag pole. I'll get it. No, you just drive the boat. Keep going towards him. Slow down. He's a big one.
Slow down.
There he is. Oh, yeah. Ah, the tag went in. There he is. Look at the size of him. Oh, there's a shark's got him! Look at the size of the Mako that's got him! Holy! Just keep filming that. A massive shark has got it. That is the biggest Mako I've ever seen, bro. Look at that. Oh my gosh.
Be careful, mate, he's getting aggro.
He's got our swordfish, and Mako has grabbed my big sword. Look! Look at the size of that swordfish, and it is getting ravaged by an even bigger Mako shark. We want to get the sword back. Grab a hold of the gaff. I'm just going to try and get our swordfish back. But be careful of this Mako. Be careful of this Mako. Grab the bill. Okay, here, come give me a hand. He got me with his bill. Look at the shark right here. Right here, right here. Right here, look at the size of that. That is the biggest Mako I have ever seen. That is massive. Okay, I'm just going to get a gaff and put it in. Start the motor. Go forward. Go forward. Start the motor. Neutral.
You're joking.
Oh, we've lost power somehow. Oh, we've got nothing. We've got nothing. That leads
come off the back of the ignition.
Oh, that shark's gonna eat the sword. We'll try shorting the solenoid. Quick, grab a screwdriver.
Oh.
He's trying to defend his catch from us. He is trying to keep us at bay from what he thinks is his kill. Look at him, he doesn't care about it. Look at the size of that Mako, bro. Look at the size of him, man. He's gonna stay here with his kill. That is a big sword, and that has just been smoked by an even bigger Mako shark. Well smoked. And at the moment, we've bumped the terminal off the motor and it's stalled and we can't start it. Oh, look at that Mako. Look at him, he's just cruising around us like he don't care. Okay, we're started. Okay, what a friggin' drama. Pass me a gaff pole, please. Just stay neutral, go neutral. Gaff.
Where?
Gaff pole. Pole, port side. Got him on the gaff now at least. Okay, watch out for that shark. Keep an eye on the shark at all times because he will come to claim his catch.
That is madness.
That is a big Mako, bro. That's a bigger. I've seen some Makos, mate, but I've never seen anything quite like that. That was big. It just smashed a 300. What was a 300 kg sword? There's not quite so much of it left now. Oh, here it is. Here's our shark over this side. Half itch this around the bill. Get this around the bill. Quick. Coming up to bite it. We want to get it away. It's old man in the sea stuff. This is just old man in the sea, isn't it? Hand lining a swordfish, yep. We're going to have to get him around to the back or we'll tip the boat over.
He's in behind.
Look at the size of that fin. That is an incredible Mako. He doesn't care about us, does he? He does not care for us.
Up to you.
Wow. That is a big shark. When they get to that size, they've just got no respect for us. He's just smashed a 300 kg swordfish, which is incredibly disappointing because of course I wanted to release it. Having caught one a couple of weeks ago, we kept to eat. He's got a bit of a feed from it. We'll get a bit of a feed from it. And I tell you what, it puts you in awe of nature when you see that happen in front of you. You think something like a swordfish is as big and tough as they get. And they're tough, but the Mako, even to catch that swordfish when it was jumping, that swordfish jumped, just landed. Oh, we've got some smoke. Here he is. Look. Man, I just hope this camera shows the size of him. That is unreal, man. Look at the state of this boat, man. That is mayhem like I've never seen before. Tangling hand lines, bloody jumping sword, going nuts. And then the bloomin' kill switch gets bumped on the motors and we knock a lead off trying to fix it. And we'd start it with a screwdriver by shorting out the solenoid and the starter. We've been here, what, an hour? And we've seen this in an hour's fishing. You still want to watch snapper fishing? Really? Yeah, I know, we'll show some snapper. Don't worry, snapper's cool too. We're worried about the Mako, look at the size.
Yeah.
Come on, look at the size of that albatross, it's making our fish look small. Oi, get out of it! We're really sharing our swordfish around today, aren't we? Everyone's getting a bit. Get out, look at the size of that. Look at Albie. On three. One, two, three, go.
One, two, three.
Now, so at this stage, I can really appreciate the power of this thing propelling itself 3 or 4 meters in the air and doing a full flip. Although with a big Mako up your backside, you'd probably jump pretty high too.
It's coming up, bite it.
Come on, quick bro. Oh, a bit of blood and guts in there. Look at that tail, it's finally just fallen off. It was hanging on by a thread. And that's what the Mako does. They take away the motor. They always go straight to the tail to immobilise big prey like this. I've seen it before, this is how they take them down. You can see the big bite radius. He's coming here, boom, taking away the tail. He know the swordfish can't go anywhere. And then you'll see the way, and he's still here. He's cruising around slowly. Any other shark would panic, they'd rush into feed while there's all that blood and frenzy. Not the Mako. He knows that while it's still thrashing around, it could harm him. He waits until it's bled out, is dead. That sword is no longer a danger to him, and he will come in and he will feast himself, because a swordfish floats. They've obviously done this before. If he'd attack the marlin, he'd have to eat straight away because the marlin will sink down to the bottom, 1,000 meters down here. But the swordfish floats, and this guy here knew it. And he might have got 20 or 30 kilos out of some of those bites out of the other side of the fish. But that's just a snack, 20 or 30 kilos for a Mako that size. Now, because this swordfish is literally wedged into my boat, it is really hard to show you just the bulk through here. I mean, this is right next to the tail. And look at the girth down here. This is where they carry all of that weight and generate all that power. And it's just been smashed through in one bite. You just saw it. That shark had a hold of this swordfish. It had a hold of it, it was ragdolling it. And this ruined meat down here will cut away this, and I think we will leave it here for the shark. He's had a bit of a snack on the other side, and we'll leave him this little bit of meat to eat. No hooks, no strings attached. Fair's fair, Mr. Mako. You get this bit, and me, my family, Julian's family, and most of the people that live in town here are gonna enjoy a bit of this fish. He won't eat it first pass, I'll just pick. Yeah, well, he would have seen that, he'll go back around and eat that next. Birds are keeping it up, that's all right.
Oh, look at that, the old albatross got it.
Here he comes. He's coming to claim that off the birds. Yep. Oh, and there he goes. He's got it.
Over here, over here.
He's fired up now. He's chasing us. He knows that we've got his swordfish. Well, he thinks it's his. I kind of think it's mine. I've shared a little bit with him, now he wants the rest. We'll cut him off another big chunk, eh? Here you go, mate. Oh, yeah, he's seen it. Oh, he munched it. Everyone's had their bit. The birds have had a bit. Sharks had a bit. We've had a bit. Everyone's happy. Except the swordfish. But hey, it's life and death. I'm gonna eat them. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. But if you're left wanting more, it's a good thing we've got more. Right now, you can log on anytime to ultimatefishing.tv or download the Ultimate Fishing app, because we're out here all the time, just like we are now, fishing the depths, fishing the shallows, full episodes from all around the world, and fishing action and tips, and you can watch for free at ultimatefishing.tv.